this point, we've gone over the basic operations, and then we added variables and memory access. Now we're going to move over to an important part of making a Turing machine, which is control flow. So by default, the flow of a program will execute line by line. That means at the instruction set architecture level that the PC, the program counter, is incremented by 4 every clock cycle. So we take the PC, as we saw before, we put it into an adder that has a constant 4, and therefore every clock cycle we increment it and store it back to the program counter. That will move us to the next instruction in a sequential fashion. However, what gives us a lot of strength for our machine is to use control flow. And control flow constructs are a way of executing a segment of code if something is true or false. If there's some condition, then run some code. At the ISA level, we achieve this using conditional branches. So what RISC-V provides us, which is branch if greater than or equal unsigned, that's BGEU. Branch if greater, if less than or less than unsigned, that's BLT or BLTU. Branch if equal or not equal, BQ or BNE. And branch if greater than or equal, BGE. If you actually look into these, this will basically provide us with all the conditions we need to do branches. Other things we can restructure with a bunch of these commands or by reordering the operands inside them. And this uses the B format. So the B format has the same as the I format. As we can see, the only difference is that the immediate over here is shifted to the left by 1. The reason that we shift it to the left by 1 is that all instructions are going to be aligned either at a 32 or a 16-bit alignment. And we'll discuss that when we discuss compressed instructions, that they can be at a 16-bit alignment. But that means that we do not need to go and have byte-level addressing here. We can have half-word addressing over here. And then we gain an extra bit. And so we can go to plus minus 2 to the 12 branches, instructions, plus or minus in our type of displacement addressing. Okay, so if we have some C code like this, if I is equal to J, then F equals G plus H, else F equals to G minus H. And here is our RISC-V assembler. So I'm just going to assume that I is stored in T0 and J is stored in T1, and then F is going to be in T2, G is going to be in T3, and H is going to be in T4. That's what the compiler decided. So, okay, so what we're going to have here is a branch not equal between T0 and T1. So we're checking, is I equal to J? If it is not equal, then branch to else. Else is a label over here. So if they are not equal, we're going to go over to this line. If they are equal, then what are we going to do? T2 is going to get T3 plus T4. And we saw that T3 and T4 are G and H, and we're going to store it in T2, which is F. So we basically did this, F equals G plus H. And then if then we're going to have some sort of strange command, branch if equal X0, X0. Well, we said that X0 is always hard-coded to 0, so this is always going to be branched, right? These are always going to be equal, so we're going to go to exit. So we're going to skip over the next line and finish, basically. Okay, but if these were not equal, T0 and T1 were not equal, then we would have skipped over those lines and gone directly to the else, and then that said subtract T2, T3, T4. So we did T3, which was G, minus T4, which is H, and stored it in T1. So we did this command over here. So that's how we implemented an if. We implement some of the commands in line, and some of them we skip over them with these branching options. So what we saw in the previous slide was our first type of conditional or use of go-to or use of branching in order to implement an if type of, if-else type of construct. But the other type of construct that is very useful in coding is a loop. So C actually provides several means of implementing loop. They're all the same, basically, but they're just different means of doing it for convenience. So we have, for example, a for statement where we basically know the amount of times we want to iterate over a loop, and then we use an init, limit, and increment, and then the statement inside. Or we have a while loop where we have a condition over here that we check the condition after each iteration of the loop, and if we still meet the condition, we continue it. Do is similar to while. So these are different things that C provides us. But when we go over to the assembler level, we are not going to implement these different instructions usually. What we're going to do is we're just going to do all of them with a go-to using these conditional branches that we showed above. So instead of now using, as we saw before with the if-else, a branch to jump forward, what we're going to do is actually jump backwards to repeat the same code based on some sort of a condition. So let's see how that's done. If we have some C code, some simple C code that goes over here, and we have while AI is equal to K, increment I. So it's going to run through this array and continue running through the array while the value inside the array are all constant and equal to K. That's the simple command we have over here. Now, let's just assume for convenience that A, the address of A, the pointer to A is stored in T6, that the incrementer over here, the index of AI here, is stored in T5, and this value that we're comparing to is stored in T7. So let's take our RISC-V type of assembly code, and we have this label over here called loop, which we're going to use to basically use this go-to command that's going to keep on looping back every time we iterate through, and we're going to have some condition over here that if we reach the condition, we're going to break the loop and go to this exit label. So what do we do over here? Basically, these three commands, and again, it depends on how the compiler would implement this. This is how the example is built. These three commands are going to actually put the address of AI inside T0. So how is that done? It's going to take T5, which is I. It's going to shift it left by 2. That's multiplying it by 4. So it's going to give it the address according to bytes of I. So it's going to do T5 times 4 is going to be stored in T0. And then it's going to add that to the value inside A, which is the address of the beginning of the array. So T0 is T0. Which is, again, the value of I, plus T6, which is storing the address of A, okay? So what that did is it stuck inside T0 the actual address of AI, and then it's going to load AI, the value that's stored at AI, it's going to load into T1. The next thing it's going to do is going to compare AI to K. So it's going to check this condition. Does AI equal to K? If AI does not equal to K, we have a branch not equal, we're going to jump over to exit. So we're going to change our control flow and jump over to exit and not continue with the next two commands. However, if AI is equal to K, which means we meet this condition, what we have to do is increment I by 1. So that is what we're doing here. Add I T5, which is I again, that's T5. We're going to increment it by 1. And then what we're going to do is going to repeat the loop. So we unconditionally loop back, which this is like a jump command. Branch if equal, X0 and X0, they're always going to be equal to each other, back to loop. So this is a go-to this line over here, and it's going to continue doing that until here AI is not equal to K, and then it's going to break and run out and continue running from this point on. So how do we do that basically with hardware? Well, one of the ways that we can see here is we take our instruction and we have our immediate generator. So what we need to do now with the B format is we need to take the immediate over here and shift it left by 1. However, note that this is just a rerouting of the wires. So we don't need a whole shifter over here. We just need to move the wires into one place to the left because it's always going to be shifted by 1. Of course, we need to replicate the sign bit. And we saw that the sign bit is always going to be in bit number 31. So that's kind of an easy thing to do. So once we provided this immediate, we can add it to the PC and get our branch target over here. So this is a kind of a piece of hardware that we would need to implement in order to provide our looping and our if conditions.